Hey guys, how are you doing? So here are the top iOS 17 bugs and problems that users are experiencing after the update. I have collected, few reports from the users, using older iPhone models to up to latest iPhone models. And, based on that, I'm sharing with screenshots and with some screen recordings about the problems they are experiencing. Since the release of iOS 17, Apple also continuously fixes bugs. Every 2 weeks, once we are seeing some minor updates like iOS 17.0.1 and 0.2. And right now we have 0.3 update with few bug fixes and security fixes. Still, there are few annoying bugs and, some critical issues that users are experiencing while using their iPhone. It's not just their flagship models released just last month, like iPhone 15, 15 Plus Pro, and 15 Pro Max. Also, the older iPhone models are, kind of suffering with plenty of bugs. One thing I have learned in the past 2 years with the iOS 16 and 17 is we should not update immediately. Waiting for iOS 17.1 or 17.2 and then updating our primary iPhone will definitely be a good idea to receive a better stable update. The first problem that users have reported after updating to iOS 17 is some minor amount of users have started noticing that when they try to adjust volume on their iPhone by pressing the side button, it automatically goes up and down. The volume goes up and down automatically in their iPhone, and it is not just one particular user, because more than 5 users have reported the similar issue. That confirms that it could be a problem with iOS 17. Doing a restart, of course, fixes it temporarily, but that is not a permanent solution. We need to wait for the update. And the next important thing is overheating after updating to iOS 17. People have experienced this problem since iOS 17 and 17.0.1 and 0.2 also, while charging and while using apps like camera and Facebook, Instagram. Of course, Apple recently acknowledged that, and they promised that they are working on the update, and they also blamed a little bit about the Instagram and Facebook not properly optimized their codes, so that it is causing heating issue with the iPhone 15, 15 Pro, Pro Max, and also with the older iPhone models after updating, after the user updating to the iOS 17 version. They have released iOS 17.0.3 with better optimization, and it is confirmed that right now 15 series models, and along with all the other iPhone models running iOS 17, also not getting that much heat compared to the previous 17 version. So if you are experiencing such issue, immediately update your iPhone to the latest stable version. Right now it is 7.0.3, and you will see the overheating problem getting fixed. And the next problem that older iPhone model users, even the 2 years older iPhone 13 users, maximum report is the fast battery drain problem. Even for few minutes of Instagram and Facebook or YouTube Shorts related usage, I normally say in our videos related to the battery and battery health, using Instagram with HDR content or any other video streaming in mobile data does consume a bit more battery power. That is absolutely normal. Compared to the iOS 16, users have started to notice faster battery drain, and that is kind of, will result in overall bad experience. And here you can try performing reset all settings temporarily to see whether that helps in your case or not. Also, try to reinstall Instagram and Facebook application if that two application is in the top of the battery chart and you are seeing fast battery drain problem. And the fourth one is home and lock screen bug in iOS 17. Some users are seeing more than 40% of consumption of the home and lock screen under the battery statistics page. That is definitely not normal. Thing is, like, if you are using very high resolution wallpaper on your lock screen or home screen, and if you have enabled any widgets on the lock screen, then that does consume some sort of battery power. That is absolutely normal. Based on the type of widget, like for example, if you're using a weather widget, then it constantly uses the internet and GPS, everything to keep itself updated. So in such case, the battery drain will be a bit faster and you will see more percentage consumed under the battery statistics page. Other than that, if you're not using the widget on lock screen or not using multiple widgets on the home screen, then still if you're seeing the home and lock screen screen highlighted in the battery statistics page, then it is definitely a bug in iOS 17. As you can see, it has consumed only 2%, which is absolutely normal. For your screen on time, according to that, you know, the consumption will be different. So less than 5 or, you know, less than 10% based on your usage is totally normal. Other than that, it is definitely a bug in iOS 17 that is causing the issue. In such case, you need to go to settings, general, reset, and then reset all settings. That will definitely help to fix this problem where the home and lock screen consumes more battery on your iPhone after updating to iOS 17. The next important problem that users have started to experience is iPhone not charging after iOS 17. Especially with iPhone 12, I have also experienced the same problem. Just few times, randomly, it stops charging and I have to remove the cable and reconnect again in order to make it work. One more troubleshooting step that you can try is performing a force restart, which will definitely help to fix this problem. So here you can also try another troubleshooting step where cleaning with plastic paper clips. Do not use any pins or, you know, any sharp objects trying to clean the power socket area. So it is important to clean with any plastic objects that is not too sharp. So that will definitely help to fix any problem that is caused by the dusts inside the Lightning port or USB-C port. Of course, iPhone 15 models are very new, so there is a very less chance for dust forming inside there. But if you are using older iPhone model and experiencing it, do try it. And the next important thing is the forced restart, which I have first said. You have to press and release the volume up button once, press and release the volume down button once, and then press and hold both volume down and power button, and, you know, keep on holding till the iPhone restart. Then you can try connecting your Lightning cable and you will start to see that the iPhone is charging normally. So this sort of problem is crazy. You know, after updating to iOS 17, I too experienced it in my iPhone 12. So that force start actually helped from the same problem reappearing again. And the next important thing is the incoming caller screen is not working properly. Already, after updating to iOS 17, I hate the ugly incoming caller screen, the gray color screen. You know, Apple iOS development team for choosing this gray color background for all the incoming caller screen, which definitely makes the iPhone look so ugly whenever you receive a random call, even from the contacts that you have saved in your iPhone. If you haven't set up the contacts photo, then it shows pretty ugly. The another important thing is if you have any previous profile picture set for a contact, then that contact is completely blurred out in the background and it is not visible as it was in iOS 16. That is very disappointing, and I'm currently running iOS 17.1 beta version. Shocked to see that how come no one at the Apple headquarters or in the development team is using, you know, it raises me a question whether they are using iPhone with iOS 17 running or not. Overall, seeing the incoming caller screen, you know, looking totally ugly even with or without photo. The only thing is you have to use the contact poster, the contact photo feature. Otherwise, it'll be totally ugly looking incoming caller screen. So this has to be fixed, and I think it could be possibly a bug, which I'm expecting a fix soon in the upcoming update. The seventh one is whenever you try to charge your iPhone, the wallpaper and the entire lock screen goes dark. So this has nothing to do with the always on display enabled iPhone 14 Pro and Pro Max models and the latest 15 Pro and Pro Max models. This is definitely an iOS 17 bug that is, you know, affecting older iPhone model users even. I haven't personally experienced it so far, but some users have shared the screenshots similar to this one I'm showing, that the time and everything, you know, went super dark and it is not clearly visible. Whether it could be a mess up of the standby feature, I think, but overall this bug exists and it needs a fix. The next one is phone app consuming higher amount of storage. The default phone app normally consumes less than, you know, around 500 MB or less than 1 GB. And in some cases, when we store more photos inside a profile picture custom assigned from our photo gallery, it may have slight increase. But with the recent introduction of the contact photo, the contact poster feature in iOS 17, it looks like it does consume plenty of storage. And due to some bug, users have noticed that even more than 4 GB or 5 GB is consumed by the phone application. And it is kind of in the top of the chart under settings, general iPhone storage. So this is clearly a bug which needs a fix. And right now with my iPhone 15 Plus running iOS 17.1 beta version, I can see that it is kind of a less number of amount of storage that it is consumed. But when I start to configure more contact posters, I'm afraid that it may increase. So Apple definitely needs to fix this problem. And sadly, there is no troubleshooting step available right now to fix it. The next one is custom text tone disappeared completely. If you have custom ringtones enabled, and you may see that all the custom text tones or custom ringtones have disappeared from the list. So this problem has been fixed with the iOS 17.1 beta 2 version. I have recently published a video explaining the difference with the 17.0.3, showing a different text tone series. And with the iOS 17.1 beta 1 version, they have entirely removed and replaced it with all the iOS 16 ringtones and text tones. And with the beta 2, they have fixed it finally. So once it's officially released, you will also see that getting fixed. And the next important bug that users are experiencing is notification sounds not working properly after iOS 17 update. Some of the iPhone users noticed that none of the notifications, app-related notifications, WhatsApp and so on, were not working. And the best troubleshooting step that I like to suggest is go to settings, general, reset, and you have to perform reset location and privacy settings. That will definitely help to fix the problem. And as you can see, some of the iOS 17 bugs can be fixed with a simple restart or all settings reset, but not all of them can be fixed, which can only be done from Apple's side by releasing an update that is strong and solid and proper tested. I hope only then we will be able to get a stable iOS 17 experience. What do you overall think about iOS 17? Do share your thoughts in the comment section. For more, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you and have a wonderful day.